Hello again, I'm back. I'm home now, as you can see. I just got home yesterday. And hi, baby. Hi. It's pretty good. He's a little booger guy. Hi, say hi. He's eating an Uncrustable. So he has an Uncrustable on his neck and he's dirty. Dirty babies are happy babies. So that's hot, baby. Hot, hot. No, that's yucky. And then I got my little berry butt over here. Here. Say hi.
Hi.
That's my 7-year-old Nico. He's playing, looks like Spider-Man. And there's my Pixel. Anyways, let's turn around. My little lovey by me. And Damien, my 13-year-old's in his room playing PS4.
Down the
yeah, pretty much what I'm left with. It's okay, whatever. Sorry, I look like a hot mess today, but I just wanted to fill you guys in on what was going on because I got some terrible news, and you guys always uplift me with your comments. Seriously, I read them and I just feel uplifted. So what happened was I had a fever. I woke up with another fever a couple days ago, and I called my oncologist, and they said just come to the office at 3:30. And I called him about 8 o'clock in the morning. So I slept the rest of the day because I was severely tired. And then I ended up going to the oncology office. My husband took me at 3:30. And when I got there, my heart was like racing. And I was tachycardic, I guess he said. So he sent me straight to the hospital. So when I got to the hospital, they ended up admitting me again. And yeah, they ran all the tests again, and the next morning when I woke up, I had a severe headache, and I told the doctor at the hospital, you know, about my severe headache, which I don't get headaches. Even though I have cancer in my brain, I do not get headaches. What I did get was I was seeing black spots, and I was seeing zigzags, but I never had headaches, so I was really concerned, like, why I'm getting headaches, and it's like severe headaches. So I ended up telling the doctor, like, I took my pain pill and they gave me Tylenol on top of the pain pill and the headache was still there. And he was like, you guys, I missed a whole bunch of stuff to tell you. So anyways, I'm like really, really tired today. Okay, I got to the hospital. Let me back up. I got to the hospital and they ran a CT scan and it showed that I had a clot in my lung. That's what it was, a clot in my lung. And my baby's getting tissues. He's putting tissue everywhere. A clot in my lung. So they gave me Eliquis. They gave me something else in an IV to break up a blood clot. And now I'm on Eliquis. Getting that. So they admitted me and from there. And then the next morning I woke up and I had a severe headache, and I told him, and he said he's going to order a CT scan because he suspects I have a brain bleed because I'm on blood thinners and whatever. So he sent me for a CT scan, and he found something I wish he never would have told me because I'm like super paranoid now. He said he found out that I did not have a brain bleed, but I had a stroke. So I'm, of course, freaking out. Like, what? When? He said within the last couple days. So from there, that was just a regular CT scan. They ordered a CT scan with contrast, and they ordered a brain MRI. So then I went down for a bunch of tests. They wanted to see the blood flow in my neck. He comes back to my room. And he squats down at my bedside. And when doctors squat down at your bedside, you know it's bad. And he said, not only did you have one stroke, you have had many strokes. He sees a whole cluster, I guess, of strokes I've had. Huh? What? Did you wash your hands with soap? Remember, always wash your hands with soap. So, I'm like, what? I'm like, how does... Sorry. How did this happen? Like, what? You know, so right now, they had me on blood thinners. They did send me home, even though I found all this stuff yesterday. There's nothing more they can do but put me on blood thinners. I'm on Eliquis. I'm on a whole bunch of medication right now. I'm on antibiotics because they don't know what the source of my fever was. Why I initially went to the hospital, they don't know. They said it wouldn't be caused by anything that they saw. So they put me on antibiotics for broad spectrum antibiotics for anything. I'm on Eliquis. I'm on steroids still, and they gave me a refill of my pain meds because my chest's been hurting really bad lately, and my head. I woke up this morning with the biggest headache, and I'm getting nervous because, like, now every time I get a headache, I'm gonna think I'm having a stroke. Ugh, what the hell is going on? So, anyways, I've had many strokes apparently, which is weird because the last week I've been having headaches. And good news is, looks like all my brain lesions are shrinking. It's hard to hear, like, okay. They tell me, oh, good news, your brain lesions are shrinking, but bad news is you've had many strokes. It's like a roller coaster of emotions I'm going through, like yesterday. Oh, my baby's looking out the window, yelling out the window. Oh, today was so hard to wake up. It's like 1:45 right now, and I couldn't get up to 12. I feel so bad because the baby, my husband's at work right now. He took off a lot of days, so he can't take off any more days. But I'm so tired today. I'm just chilling on the couch on my little vibrating pad. This thing, I love, love, love this thing. I don't know if I showed you guys this. I think I did. See this remote? It's the greatest invention ever, seriously. But I'm okay. I'm just sitting here, and as long as the baby's fed and changed, he's good. He doesn't match, but I don't care. My son helped me get him dressed, so that was that. I don't know where these strokes are coming from. He's guessing that my lung clap broke off some pieces and traveled to my brain and caused many other strokes. And now I'm terrified, like, I don't know. I feel like I'm going downhill fast. It's like one thing's good, and then, like they said, your chest infection's is clearing up, and it looks much better. When I did my chest CT to see if my chest infection was getting worse or better, when I first got to the hospital, but you have a blood clot in your lungs. So it's like a really emotional roller coaster. Throw it in the garbage if you're done with that. Nico, throw it in the garbage if you're done with it. So, I ordered some. Tell my husband I just want to shave this off. Like, it just. This just looks hideous. I'm just. Yeah. I don't know. It is what it is. It's okay. But, anyways. I just really could use some uplifting comments because this is a lot to take in. You're like, don't cut yourself because you can bleed. If you're bleeding anywhere, I'm like, oh my gosh. I don't intend to cut myself, so I don't intend to cut myself anyways. But I'm just saying, like, it was so hard to wake up this morning and take my pills, and I don't know, I was just really, really tired. I am just like terrified I'm gonna wake up with a fever, and they don't know the source of this fever. It could be my body's way of telling me I have blood clots in my body. I don't know, but I think to myself, when did I have these strokes? It must have been in my sleep, and thank God I'm fine. Like, I don't have any symptoms. Like, they did a stroke test on me, like, put your arms in front of you and hold them out, and I pass the flying colors. I'm talking, I'm not slurring my speech, I'm not. And then, just so you guys know, I have no blurry vision. I don't see black spots at all. So it's good news that the lesions in my brain are going away, or shrinking. But having a stroke is scary. Like, what? And not just one stroke, many strokes? What? That was the last thing I expected to hear.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Nicole. come here.
Oh my gosh. I don't know. I don't, like, I'm so depressed. Like, I'm just, oh, can I catch a break? I just want to do stuff with the kids. Like, I don't know. Like, what if I go somewhere with the kids and I have an actual, like, not an actual stroke, but like a stroke where I slur my speech or half my face is drooping because, you know, they have a time frame of getting that blood clot out. The doctor's sitting there telling me this, and I'm like, oh my gosh. Like, I could be paralyzed the rest of my life. And what if, I know I shouldn't say what if, but like, why am I having all these strokes? Like, this is scary. Anyways, I am awake now, thank God. I snapped out of it and I can, hi babies. I can spend some time with my kids. What are you doing? What are you doing, silly? What are you doing, sir? I really want to make some uplifting videos, but I just had to update you guys on that because I think that is just crazy. I don't know. Why did I get a blood clot in my lungs? Is that due to this and her too? There's no way I'm putting that stuff back in my body. I decided I am not going to put that stuff back in my body. It wreaked havoc on me, and I don't know. And, I don't know. I'm like really, really depressed. Really, really depressed. Yes, that's cool. He's showing me Spider-Man on his, what is that called? What game are you playing? I don't even know these game systems, because, anyways, I just sit here with the kids all day long. I feel bad. I just wish I could take them to the zoo. Zoo a la carte's coming up here. Whoever knows what Zoo a la carte is, it's like a bunch of vendors, food vendors, and it's just fun. I took them last year. Oh, ow! He just pinched my toe with his fingernails, and I guess I got to cut him. Oof.
It's a pixie hide.
Show you guys my kitchen table here. It's fingerprints all over. I don't know. They made a mess. This is our new good dining room table. It's huge. Yeah. So, you got a robot. I love it.
You're my little guy.
Trampoline. There's my little guy. Yeah. Anyways, there's my table. It's, somebody broke my picture frame. It's, has a pedestal. See the big pedestals. So, we scotch guarded it. There's tons of cans. Oh, did you start that vacuum? He started the vacuum and he ran. He ran with all his little might. Uh-oh, no, start a vacuum. There it goes. Anyways, there's a table. And I do have tablecloths for it, fall tablecloths. So I'm gonna put some fall tablecloths on it. It's okay, baby, come here. Come here, baby. Oh, it's got mirrors. Look what he did. This and this. Come here, honey. Come on, papas. You stay out there, Missy. You scared of the vacuum. He's so funny. He started it. Turn it back to me here. Okay. Oh, so anyways, I don't know. We'll see what. I meet with my oncologist. Today's Friday. I meet with him on Monday. I don't even know what to say. It's just, ever since I took this in HER2 chemo, I've been in a hospital and things been going really downhill. What's next? All I keep thinking is, what is next? Sorry, my lips are really dry. Pixie's playing with her toy. So funny. She's throwing it in the air. Anyways. God, having strokes. Like, I just can't get over it. I am so floored by this. Like, what? Are you sure? Like, I was asking, are you sure? I'm like, definitely. That's why they did 3 different tests. And I'm glad that they're like on it. They like running all these tests and everything. And I'm surprised they sent me home yesterday because my heart rate was still really high when I left. And I don't know if this is in HER2 too, but my heart rate is like between 130 and 180 again. It just always pounding. I don't understand why. It like goes really, really fast. So they did an EKG on me before I left and said, that's my normal rhythm. I don't know. All this stuff is so scary. It's just like, if I never took this in HER2 medication, I would never be through any of this. I think they need to pull it. I don't know. It's. I guess it works for some people, and I guess it could have shrank my brain mets, but I think it was the brain radiation that shrank my brain mets. I don't know. I'm frustrated. I wouldn't say I'm ready to give up, but seriously, this has been a lot. This is mentally, it's draining. I'm mentally drained. Immensely drained. I wish I could like actually get on here and like have good news. But anyways, I am going to jump off here because I'm gonna relax. And anybody else been in a situation? I highly doubt it. Anybody taken HER2 on here? I would like to hear your stories because I am in a group on Facebook and. Oh, I cringe every time they say I'm going to go for my mother's going to go for her first in HER2 treatment. I cringe because I know what havoc it can wreak on your body. And I guess it's good because there's good stories, positive stories, but I don't know why this is happening to me. I don't know, but.
What did you see? Goku, Mom. Look at Goku.
Goku and Spider-Man. Yeah. Oh my goodness, what a combination. Anyways, I guess I'm going to rock this hairdo for a while. I don't know why this is not falling out, but like the rest of my head is completely bald. It's just very strange. So I think I'm just going to shave my head because it's so balding. It bothers me. I bought some head wraps and it's too hot. I'm always hot because of the steroids I'm on. Anyways, I can't believe I was having strokes. And the doctor said most likely I was having them in my sleep. I didn't notice them because they're happening while I was sleeping. I'm really grateful that I don't have any side effects. Permanent. Like, I could be paralyzed right now. My uncle had a stroke and he was paralyzed. Until he died. He died like a month after he had a stroke. This is just, I can't believe this. It's hard to wrap my head around, seriously. I am. Watch this. He's watching the vacuum cleaner. He's like terrified of that vacuum cleaner and he is watching it. Where's the vacuum? What's the matter, baby? You scared of vacuum? Oh. See a shirt, T Mom? That's when my sister put on my benefit and made the kids all shirts for my benefit. It says T Mom. All the kids says to Mom. And the front says, I don't know what the front says. And it's just a heart. Look, he's looking.
That is a combination.
There
it is.
Right there. He's, look at him. He's just watching it. Look at Pixie. She has her little toy. See? She said, okay. I don't feel like cleaning at all, so my house is a mess and I don't care. This is barely ever done. I always care about my house, but I don't care today because I am just, I'm so tired. Nico. Nico got a haircut, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
That's what fun you
did. Judge Judy. Anybody else like watch Judge Judy?
Me?
You're funny. Okay, I'm going to jump off here because I got to get off my phone. And I will talk to you guys later. I promise the next video is going to be a positive one. Probably me doing something with the kids. Hopefully. All right, bye.